your boy Indian Gooner in the house. Another video on the course, but this is a special video, a special series, Culprits of Arsenal. Yes, Culprits of Arsenal is a special series wherein I would want to discuss about the defense of Arsenal and the culprits who led Arsenal down, who led Arsenal to concede a goal. And this is a real special thing because we need to know what our mistakes were, and that's the only way to improve. So without stopping, without any further ado, let's go on with the video. And if you have not subscribed to my channel, definitely subscribe to my channel. I post daily Gooner stuff, such Gooner stuff that you would feel that I'm actually speaking on behalf of you. So let's go on with the video. So if you're a Gooner and you've seen that Arsenal have been conceding or Arsenal have been trailing by the end of the first half, that's been the showcase of us this season in the Premier League. But nonetheless, what are the timings, or the timeline at which we concede more? It is known that from the start of the match to the first 10 minutes, Arsenal conceded 6%, have conceded 6% of the goals, while 11 to 20, Arsenal have conceded 14%, 21 to 30, 10%, 31 to 40, 10% again, and 41 to 50, 18%. That means majority of the percentages are actually in the first half of the game. Second half, which suggests is 51 to 60, only 2%. While the next one is 61 to 70, they concede 20% of the goals. Yes, 61 to 70, our defense tend to sleep more. That means a laid back attitude, I must say. But 71 to 80, again 2%, and nonetheless, 81 to 90, we have conceded 16% of goals. 16% is a real high amount. You know, that is exactly the laid-back attitude of Arsenal, and I think that has led to a lot of problems. But nonetheless, let's talk about who has been the major culprit. The errors that have led to the goals. Number one person who has actually caused more errors than anybody else is Bad Leno. 5 errors leading to goal, followed by Granit Xhaka with 2, Matteo Guendouzi 1, Alex Iwobi 1, Siad Kolasinac 1, Stefan Ritzsteiner 1, and Skodran Mustafi 1. These are the stats which I've got from the website of Premier League itself. Nonetheless, I know that Mustafi is the biggest culprit. Why? Because he's done some shrewd fouls, some unnecessary silly fouls that have led to, you know, not clearing well, or actually trying to tackle unnecessary positions, giving set pieces. And there are majority of the teams who are better in set pieces than Arsenal in this Premier League, and they've actually gone on to, you know, capitalize on those situations where Arsenal haven't. And that is my major point why I have made this video. I think this is the reason why, because we've been error prone so much that we've conceded 51 goals. Thank God Manchester United have conceded more goals than us, because that's actually a little bit of proud thing to say that we've conceded less than Manchester United. But nonetheless, they are not our target. Our target is Manchester City and Liverpool. We need to actually try to, you know, go and compete with them. And to all the fans, to all the Gooners who think that next season is ours, no, my friend, no. No, next season is not ours. We are in the rebuilding phase. We don't even have a squad to play Champions League, League Cup, FA Cup and Premier League together. So you need to understand that there will be a sacrifice in the next season as well. I think FA Cup and League Cup will again be sacrificed by Unai Emery, because his whole idea and his whole energy will be to again qualify for the Champions League. And I think his priority will be definitely be Champions League and Premier League.